obviously, I am a behavior analyst and my significant other is not. So there's a lot of those conversations and bringing him into that sphere and like what we study. So my dog, my male, Arkham, when we first got him, he did have the zoomies quite often at a certain time of night. Me knowing that he's very attention maintained, I started to notice that he would do the zoomies and the very loud aggressive barking, not aggressive like I'm going to attack you, is more like, hey, I want your attention. And then everybody would turn and yell at Arkham, stop doing that, don't do this. And I'm like, don't you see how he's just continuously barking? You guys are reinforcing his behavior. And they're like, well, then what do you want us to do? I was like, watch this. I like turned my whole body around and my back to him stopped immediately. He literally was like, what the hell? Look at me. Like, look what I'm doing. He's like, that doesn't work. I'm like, turn around. And he turned around on the couch. Like, literally, we're both facing the backs of the couch. Stopped doing it. Walked away. And then from there on out, every time he started doing that, we would just put our back to him. And then he would completely stop.
Planned ignore or, you know, whatever, you know, ignoring is a real thing. You have to do it, right? If the attention, it's a, you know, attention function.
Especially with like crate training and stuff.
Yeah.
And so, it's hard. I'm not going to say it's easy because it's very difficult. Listening to your dog crying whine, I get it.
So, and I had one of those recently where a dog was, she was waking up 2:30, 3:30 in the morning and, hey, I want to go out and hunt. Then ignore her. I know it's going to be tough. Put some earphones on, whatever you need to do, right? She doesn't have to pee or ignore. Okay. So, did that for like two nights and then she's like, well, I'm noticing a little bit different. She's a little louder and extinction or extinction burst. So then explaining that for each individual dog, it's never the same. It's never the same as much as I want it to be. So I can cookie cutter and like, bam, I know what this is. Bam. You recognize, but no, this one, there's two functions here. I said, start a routine at night. Just like a baby, just like a toddler, right? You know, we have the lavender soaps for baths. We have, you know, music playing. You got, you know, Beethoven in the background. Mm-hmm. She's like, really? And so she starts doing it. And I said, start like 15, 20 minutes prior to your bedtime. Mm-hmm. Like, hey, signaling this means it's calm down time and we're done for the night. And so short story, although it's too late for that, she did that and it worked. It worked. And I was like, yes. I said yes to her, but in the background, I'm like jumping. I'm doing the cartwheels now, you know. So.